This is the road to the World Cup. It was the biggest esports event ever. 10 weeks of qualifying led to 2 days of epic competition in NYC. Three teams, FaZe Clan, E11, and Kungarna, were selected for an exclusive G Fuel boot camp leading up to the World Cup.
Boot camp is really nice.
The house is amazing, a really good setup.
FaZe Clan is the established org that went into the World Cup with a huge following and even bigger expectations.
Top three or bust.
Kungarna is a new org with a new way of thinking. It's safe to say the team founder is looking to build his kingdom.
It's been a long road to get here. We've been working hard over the past couple months. Now we're doing decent. Got a few players around the top 20.
I knew I had a chance for the World Cup. I just kept grinding and grinding until it happened.
E11 is a Canadian-based team led by a hockey superstar who knows what it takes to win.
The best players in the world are here, so excited to see it.
He's a big name in the sports community, probably one of the best.
On day one of this $30 million weekend, it was all about the duos. For FaZe, Nate Hill and Funk finished a respectable 31st in the world. But on this day, it was the Young Guns who came through big time. Team members Mongrel, Mega, and Dubs all finished top 10 and walked away with a combined $825,000.
That's crazy, oh my God.
For E11, their big winner on day one was 16-year-old Item.
Item came eighth, so really happy for him.
But for one of the team's most feared duos, Stompy and Chinkin, they almost didn't even make the tournament.
Stompy came to me and, you know, he explained that he really wasn't feeling well. Turned out he had a huge heat rash, covers everywhere that he had clothes on.
But like a true champion, Stompy persevered, and this deadly duo finished 25th in the world.
You know what, I have had a lot of experiences with the highs and lows of professional sport. The guys, for a lot of them, it was the first time in front of a massive crowd, and I thought they did great. They qualified for the biggest event in esport history.
In the Kungarna Kingdom, it was Little and Jay who were looking to prove themselves.
They did all right. It was some unfortunate games, but, you know, they're young. They'll be back next year. They'll be fine.
And in the biggest tournament of their lives, these young fighters ended up in 38th place. Day two meant the top 100 solo players were going head to head in the most elite battle royale ever. For FaZe Clan, 14-year-old Mongrel led the way, finishing 13th overall. Dubs was just behind in 15th spot. Both young players walked out of the solo finals with $150,000. It's safe to say that Mega and Funk didn't perform as well as they wanted, but at least Funk seemed to have a sense of humor about it all. He knows he'll be back. For E11, Stompy had to put his duo's disappointment behind him to focus on the solos.
I just talked to him and told him that he just has to reset and just refocus and get ready for today. And he's confident. He's confident in his abilities.
He battled hard and finished 14th in the world, winning another $150,000. For his teammate, Klusha, a top 50 finish in solos meant the young Dane had a $100,000 weekend.
At the end of the day, I'm just really proud of all our guys. They did amazing.
The big story in the kingdom was an incredible comeback from Thatch. Going into the fifth game, the young Canadian wasn't even in the top 50, but he stormed back to finish 10th in the world and earned a $225,000 paycheck.
I was just screaming around. It was a really good time.
Cementing their reputation as the partner in esports, G Fuel put on what was an ambitious and, in the end, unparalleled boot camp. It helped prepare three great teams for the world stage and the biggest weekend of their lives.